हेलो।
हाँ जी
अरे क्लास है अभी 11 बजे से, व्हाट्सएप मैंने किया था।
सर, यस सर, ज्वाइन कर लूंगा आपकी।
हाँ, अरुण को भी कह देना। हेलो। हाँ, ज्वाइन करो ना। हेलो। हेलो। हेलो, एम आई ऑडिबल टू यू? हेलो हेलो, एम आई ऑडिबल टू ऑल ऑफ यू? हेलो।
यस सर,
ओके
यस सर।
ओके ओके, तो शुड आई स्टार्ट? है ना। सो
यस सर।
हाँ ठीक है। हम लोग पहले पिछले स्लाइड में वो डिजीज ट्रांसमिशन थ्रू सीमेन, है ना, इन डोमेस्टिक एनिमल वी आर स्टडिंग सिंस प्रीवियस क्लास। This is second class on that particular topics, and we have
hello
cover. हाँ क्या हुआ दीपशिका?
Hello.
हाँ आवाज आ रही है तुम्हारी? You are audible.
सर आवाज नहीं आ रहा है.
But your voice is coming. So you are audible to me. Hello. हेलो.
यस सर.
दीपशिखा को आवाज नहीं आ रही है.
यस सर मेरे पास आ रहा है दीपशिखा के पास.
हाँ हाँ
यस सर.
अच्छा अभी कर देते हैं. अब हो गया ठीक हो गया. ओके
नेटवर्क नहीं होगा सर.
हाँ हाँ हो सकता है देयर माइट बी प्रॉब्लम. सो दिस इज यूनिट 4 क्लास सेकंड क्लास ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक. वी हैव कवर अप टू this introduction list of disease transmitted through the semen, different diseases, MSP is what? Minimum standard protocol. And every government has their own minimum standard protocols, and through which all the semen station of India is guided by minimum standard protocol, which is been given by the government of India, a certain protocols under which the semen bank should to be work under that protocols. And finally, we will go to conclusions. Introduction, we have already studied in the previous class. You know what it that semen is the major way by which infertility in the female has been absorbs. Many of the animals are infertile only due to the semen of infective organisms or the presence of the organism, pathogenic organism into the semen. So it is I want to make you understand that semen is very important. Artificial insemination is a very good work, is a very good old a very good biotechnology. Matlab it is a simple form of a biotechnology, it is artificial insemination. No, I want to stress here that you know it's a semen artificial insemination very much advantageous, but you cannot ignore the artificial insemination also help in spreading of the many of the infectious or infertility in female through semen, because of many of the pathogenic organisms are found in the semen. So here I want to clear it. I want to clear it that the semen artificial insemination, no doubt it's good, but we have to monitor the way by which we can stop or prevent the infective or spreading disease through semen. If any organization is running semen bank or semen production unit, but that organization or that body should monitor this semen collection methodology, how they are preparing. How they are preparing the doses and how they can stop or prevent this prevent for spreading of the contagious or very infectious diseases which will be responsible for infertility in female animals. Let's take an example, campylobacteriosis. You know it's how it is campylobacteriosis, also known as a campylobacter or vibriosis. This is also known as a vibriosis. This is a bacteria. This is gram-negative bacteria which is involved for infertility in female, and this pathogenic organism usually found in the semen of bulls. So campylobacteriosis. Similarly, you have studied infectious IBR, infectious bronchiotracheitis (IBRT). This disease is also a virus of a herpes group, herpes virus. It is a member of a herpes virus. This virus help in not help but it help in prevent help in spreading of the disease called the IBR. The lesion many of the case when you are examining in a cattle vagina, it will be a like a pinhead type grow. Some growth will be you will see at the vulval mucosa or the vaginal mucosa. There is pinhead type. This give very itching. This is a viral type. You can see in net also. It is there picture lesion of the IBR disease, IBRT. This disease is very much infective to the females. This disease comes from the semen of bull. And another one disease is the brucellosis. Brucellosis, you know, it is a bank disease, also known as a highly contagious disease. It creates abortion in the last trimester of the cattle. It starts from 5 months to 9 months. In between period, if you are suspecting any cow that has been aborted, any fetus, certainly there will be a more chance, or 90% chances of that the animal may have brucellosis. And not only by this only, if a cow is aborting their fetus at the 6 months or the second last trimester, certainly animal will have their retention of placenta cases. Maximum the brucellosis has been found the cow which is having retention of placenta cases. ROP cases are mostly, if you are handling any case is having a retention of placenta, you are examine a cow, has been reported that animal is having retention of placenta. Sometimes it will call jhar nahi gir paya, placenta nahi gir paya after pasturation. So there is possibility that the animal may have suspected case of brucellosis or infection. Actually, these diseases are found in that animal which is having retention type of problems, retention of placenta. So these are the signs, symptom, or last stage of parturition, animal last trimester of parturition, the chances of abortion is more. Brucellosis, not only it causes disease in the female but also in the male. Male it causes orchitis or infertility in the male also. So disease, if you are handling the semen, then your priority to be to remove or any spreading disease through the semen. This should be monitored by the certain organization or the body, so that it can, the semen bank can run very good, or it stop the prevention of the disease. Because you are transporting the sometimes owner or the people who are relevant to this works, transporting semen also, transporting the semen. So there is chance of spreading of the bacteria. AI, you know, it very much in good that in, it is good in that it help in improvement of the livestock productions. It improvement in the livestock, in the genetical improvements through which a high elder calf may be produced, and that calf or bull, male animal, can be reared for the progeny testings. And so AI is beneficial, but that AI, artificial intelligence, should be run under the closed monitoring system to stop the prevention of the disease through semen. This is another one disease, is Trichomonas fetus. Trichomoniasis, it is a organism, it is a protozoal organism. This is protozoa. It reside in the penis of the bull, prepuce of the bull, and it help in early abortion in the cattle. So if you are having semen, and that semen is having such type of protozoa, certainly that will create a disease in the female. And if animal get successfully conceived, and there is chance of early abortions, then there is chance of that to come about within 3 months after the conception. So this Trichomonas fetus is also should to be checked while you are doing artificial insemination. Another one disease is bovine viral diarrhea. This is also a disease. This is a viral type of disease. This is contagious disease, and sometimes it infect the human also. So animal in it. Bull is transporting, or if bull is by semen, if you are depositing in a female reproductive tract, the chance that there will be a conception failure or repeat breeding or endometritis type of disease will be in semen. So guideline has been made by the OIE. OIE is what? This is the International Organization है ना, ऑफिस ऑफ इंटरनेशनल डेस्क जुडिस, यू नो व्हाई, व्हाट इज द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ ओआई दीपशिखा? हेलो दीपशिखा है क्या? हेलो अरुण?
यस सर।
हाँ, व्हाट इज ओआईई?
ओआईई यस सर,
क्या है पूरा नाम बताइए।
इंटरनेशनल ऑफिस है सर, ऑफिस ऑफ
ओआईई, ऑफिस ऑफिस ऑफ इंटरनेशनल डेस्क एपिजूटिक्स, है ना। दिस इज ओआई, ओआई इज अ बॉडी, दिस इज इंटरनेशनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ओआई। इट वर्क है ना टू स्टॉप द ट्रांसमिशन ऑफ डिजीज फ्रॉम कंट्री टू कंट्री। ओआई हैज गाइडेड एन लिस्ट ए एंड लिस्ट बी, है ना। द ओल्ड क्लास पेशेंट इज नॉट एबल टू ओआई, ओल्ड क्लास पेशेंट इज नॉट एबल टू ओआई लिस्ट बी, बोथ आर ओल्ड बट दे मेक द made the two lists A and B. There is a difference A and B. So many of the digits can come under the list A, many of the digits come under list B. So transmissible digits that are considered to be socio-economic or public health point within country, you see the difference. Within country, list B under within country and list B the international. You will be given a PPT, you will study. In the OI list, in the OI, by the OI, the list A includes the foot and mouth digits, vesicular stomatitis, rinderpest, pest disturbance, contagious, lumpy skin. These are the digits to the more chances of transmission of the disease through the semen. This is the OI list, and our country has made their own minimum standard protocol by which you should monitor, you should to stop certain disease by doing certain examination or the serological tests. Suppose a cow is suffering from, or the bull is suffering from brucellosis. So, the brucellosis is suffer kar raha hai bull, so some of the tests are available, hai na, diagnosis of the disease. Jaise RBPP, Rose Bengal, hai na, Rose Bengal test karte hain RBPP. RBPP kya hota hai? Hello. हेलो
हेलो यस सर।
हाँ, आरबीपीटी टेस्ट का नाम बताइए आप। आरबीपीटी ब्रुसेलोसिस, देखिए
ब्रुसेला के लिए होता है सर टेस्ट सर।
हाँ, तो आरबीपीटी का
रोज बंगाल टेस्ट,
रोज बंगाल टेस्ट केवल कहने से नहीं होगा। देखिए ये पूरा नाम रोज बंगाल प्लेटलेट टेस्ट, देख रहे हो लिखा हुआ रोज बंगाल प्लेट टेस्ट आरबीपीटी टेस्ट। दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टेस्ट एंड दिस टेस्ट इज रूटीनली डन इन दी आवर लेबोरेटरी वेटनरी अंडर द वेटनरी लैब डायग्नोस्टिक। डॉक्टर पंकज कुमार इज डूइंग रूटीनली दिस रोज बंगाल प्लेट टेस्ट, है ना। Or many of the molecular diagnostic method is also to know the, to you can know, they say suppose RT-PCR examinations through which a gene of that bacteria is can be checked or can be found through the RT-PCR examination, real time polymerase chain reactions. Many of the diseases of genetic importance or the venereal disease, this can be diagnosed by molecular method, and this molecular method involves real-time polymerase chain reactions. So, blue tongues and a sheep pox, a prion sumer, these diseases all are transmitted through the semen. Ajiski disease, leptospirosis, bovine brucellosis, genetic campylobacteriosis, this is known as the vibriosis also, tuberculosis, OI list B, this is known as OI list B, B within the country, and disease transmitted also in bovine, in IBR, infected bovine, rhinotracheiasis, and बोवाइन वायरल डायरिया, फूट एंड माउथ डिजीज, ब्लू टंग, बोवाइन लीकोसिस, बैक्टीरियल डिजीज, दीज आर दी बैक्टीरियल डिजीज, IBR, IPB infection, infectious pustular vulvovaginitis. What is the sign symptom? Lesions. You see, this is the lesion. This is this erosion in the vagina. And that type of case I have observed in clinics. Can you see these lights? You are observing these lights?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is the vagina, and this you see the white black type is, this is the sign symptom of the IPBB or IBR. You could say both are same, infectious pustular vulvovaginitis or infectious, or dusra kya naam hai, infectious bovine rhinotracheitis. You see here on the penis of the bull, you see the disease. And your lesions are on the penis, macrocephalic features are here, and on the lips, prepuce, and IBR, IPB infection, disease risk through semen, one of the most common viral pathogens found in bovine semen, and excreted in semen during acute phase, and it is spit in the semen. So my attention, or I am the topic of this class, is related that in topic of the class stress that semen is having such type of organism while excreting, so it should be stopped. Diagnosis, symptom and lesion. Corneal semen test, in which pooled semen samples are included into the susceptible calf or sheath, which are then monitored by neutralizing antibodies. These are the tests which are done for the diagnosis of this IBR, IPB, corneal semen test, virus isolation test, molecular based technique PCR, jisko hum kehte hain RT-PCR, PCR examination. If any test is not able to diagnose, then molecular diagnosis will certainly help you for detection of the organism. So PCR test is above all. And other tests are also here, immunological test. PCR test is something different from the immunological test. Vaccination cows can be used to control VHD. And in many countries, they are using vaccination. Vaccine are coming in the two forms, live form or inactivated form. Live form give immunity more than the inactivated form. And dead virus, live virus, if having a vaccine having live virus, and it give immunity more than the inactivated or dead virus. And so again, there is chance of the toxicity. There is no toxicity. There is chance of infections also. Sometimes you are giving the vaccine of brucellosis to any human. Certainly the animal will develop antibody, because this you are giving the antigen in the form of the virus. So animal may have certain, sometime animal had been suffering from some other disease or has been a compromised immunity. Certainly the animal will, certainly the animal or human which has been getting the vaccine, there will develop some signs symptom of brucellosis also. If anybody is having compromised immunity. So live vaccine is very much risky. Animal may have fever, or sometimes may have brucellosis like symptoms. So in fact, inactivated or dead vaccine is very good, but this upar stare hote hue jaacha samajh rahe ho baat ko Arun? Hello.
Yes sir.
हम जो बताए समझे कि नहीं?
यस सर।
हाँ, बोवाइन वायरल डायरिया।
यस सर।
वायरल डिजीज करैक्टराइज्ड बाय हाइपोप्लेसिया ऑफ सेरिब्रम, अल्सर इन द ओरल नेजल म्यूकोसा, एसोफेगस, एवोमेजम्स। दिस इज द आरएनए वायरस। दिस इज आरएनए वायरस। यू नो द वैक्सीन फ्रॉम द आरएनए वायरस, इफ यू आर प्रिपेयर, इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट। दिस कोरोना वायरस इज हैविंग आरएनए वायरस एंड वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर production of vaccines. So bovine viral diarrhea vaccine is also a very, very important, and incubation period is 1 to 3 days. This is been found in a two form, non-cytopathic and cytopathic. So you should to study about the non-cytopathic and cytopathic. And this is the sign symptom. Bovine viral antigen has been detected in the pituitary cell of the ductus secreted amys, gland nodules, Sertoli cell, espontogonia. You see how deep it is found in the male genital tracts, bovine viral diarrhea. Virus can be present in semen from bull with persistent infection, acute infection. So this is the one important disease you should study. Blue tongues, and blue tongues is a disease of the small ruminants. Many a time this disease found in a small ruminant. This is the species in sheep. It is particularly or the specifically in sheep blue tongue is observed most common. And this blue tongues, you see tongue, it named tail tongues. You see here the tail of the sheep become bluish color. FMD, you know, this is the seven serotypes, seven antigens. And these are the serotypes, seven types. And you know, it is you are studying since undergraduate the FMD lesions. This is found in cloven-footed animals. Vesicular exanthema. This is the vesicular type of lesion has been observed, and you see under over the teeth, it is the disease. And this is common form is tiger heart myocarditis, spleen enlargements. FMD virus is easily transmitted by semen. Virus is injected in semen up to 4 days before the development of oral vesicle. So if you are giving such semen or such semen are if you are using for artificial insemination, that then you are just doing the you are just giving infection to the cow. So it should be removed, or the bull which is suffering from this FMD virus should not to be used for semen collections. Bovine leukosis virus, this is oncovirus or retroviridae families. Pathogenesis, virus can be malignant lymphoma, bovine leukosis, enlargement of superficial lymph nodes. All superficial lymph nodes will be increased in size. Microscopic feature, benign persistent lymphocytosis, enlargement of superficial lymph node, emaciated and cachectic carcass. And you see this is the lesion of the bovine leukosis. This is look like a disease of a lumpy skin disease. This animal look like that animal is suffering from lumpy skin disease. But this is not the disease, this is bovine leukosis. In lumpy skin disease, this is also the same type of lesion has been observed. Semen diagnosis by ELISA or symptom and lesion. Campylobacteriosis is this in a subspecies venerealis. This is also known as venereal disease. Venereal disease is a disease which is transmitted during the coitus. All the venereal disease is spreading through the coitus. It spread through the natural artificial insemination by both ways. Characteristics of abortion in mid gestation. If a cow is having an abortion in the mid gestation, there you can suspect that animal is suffering from the vibriosis or campylobacteriosis. Retention of placenta is more common. Mucopolar vaginal discharge, abortion. Microscopic picture, yellow is prevalent, exudate in uterine discharge. Congestion of vagina, edema of fetus, placenta, necrotic foci. These all are symptoms you will be met in the field. And I have seen this symptom or sign of the lesions. Disease risk survive service cryopreservation of semen is a disease risk through semen. Transmitted to the female cattle at natural artificial insemination caused vaginitis, cervicitis, endometritis, salpingitis. And a bull can develop a lifelong infection. So bull should be removed from the cement collection units. Infection is not accompanied by either pathological lesion or modification in characteristics of cement. Diagnosis: preputial scraping. Used to take the sample from the preputial scraping and cement from bull are usually a specimen taken for the laboratory test. And symptom: lesion or ELISA methods. Demonstration of organism. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Take control and prevention. How you can control or prevent this disease? Bull are usually tested in quarantine by culture of the preputial samples on 3 occasions to ensure they are free from the CPTs before entering AI centers. Disease free. SI is what? SI, SCC is quarantines. If you are SCC is here, meaning quarantines. It's confirmed by semi-annual test. Brucellosis, you see here, this is orchitis. Abortion in last resort, retention of placenta, orchitis in male. You see here the fetus aborted in last size. You see this is a grown, already grown fetus. Brucellosis. The organism survive in the environment in the favorable circumstances for a long period. Localized in reproductive tract of bull leading to the orchitis. Epididymitis, semen and vasculitis, enterolitis. Many a time a male has been getting inflammation to their testes and they suspect that there is a orchitis, epididymitis. But this is not. Sometimes another disease, there is symptom of orchitis. There are a lot of other disease which is having also a symptom look like that of brucellosis. It means this is orchitis, but it's not like that. Brucellosis is having something different symptom than the other disease. Bull will have said, bull will shed Brucella abortus organism in the semen during the acute phase of infection. And diagnosis, RBP. Hello.
Yes, sir.
हाँ ये हट गया था. तो ब्रुसेलोसिस है, इसमें कॉटन स्टेन स्टेन 9 वैक्सीन दिया जाता है. बिहार में भी हर हीपर्स को दिया जाता है, जो 6 मंथ का हीपर है, बाछी है
उसे.
हाँ
हेलो,
नहीं आ रहा है क्या?
स्क्रीन शेयर
नहीं. ओके तो अब दिख रहा होगा स्लाइड, दिख रहा है?
यस सर.
हाँ, तो बहुत ही कॉमन वैक्सीन है, लाइव स्ट्रेन 19 वैक्सीन एंड द किल्ड वैक्सीन बोथ आर अवेलेबल इन बिहार आल्सो. गवर्नमेंट इज डूइंग इन लार्ज स्केल द वैक्सीनेशन टू द वैक्सीनेशन प्रोग्राम फॉर कंट्रोलिंग और प्रिवेंशन ऑफ दिस ब्रुसेलोसिस. ओआई has told that should come from brucellosis free herds, should be tested. Bull should come from the brucellosis free herd, should be tested serologically a minimum 21 days after entry area with negative results. Annual testing at center with negative results. Bovine tuberculosis, you know it is bovine tuberculosis, TB. Yeah. Yaad rakhna hai par. One more very important disease is leptospirosis. This disease is very much infective. Is the this bacteria come into the urine of the dog also. Now, disease leptospira introgen and the serovars are pomoma and bacillus, L. pomoma, L. canicola, L. ectohemorrhagica. These are the serovars. These are the serotypes. Incubation less than 7 days. Pathogen direct contact with the urine of infected animal. This disease most commonly come from the dogs. Dog urine. Dog is sometimes told as reservoir. Aborted fetus and uterine discharge having this leptospira localized in kidney, resulting in acute chronic nephritis. And leptospira characteristic system, you see here, this is a high fever, anemia, icterus, jaundice, abortion, hemoglobinuria, microscopic features, hemorrhage, enlarging spleen, kidney, abortion, grayish white, foci. Disease risk, semen, artificial insemination through which transmission of the organism may be possible through the fresh or frozen semen. Leptospira can be isolated from the genital tract of the subclinical bull or transmitted in semen. Diagnosis by symptom antigen, demonstration of organism using dark field microscope. This is in bold, written. So you should remember dark field microscopy through which you can diagnose the disease. Protozoan disease characterized by the abortion, vaginitis, metritis, balanitis. In trachomoniasis, animal or male or female herbs, that if male is having such disease, will have balanitis. Trichomonas fetus, coital infection, or the venereal disease, also known as venereal disease. Disease spreading through the coitus is called venereal disease. Characteristic symptom: abortion in early pregnancy, retention of placenta, sterility, and pyometra. Trichomoniasis, prepucial scraping, you should take the sample of prepuce and usually specimen taken for laboratory test or for the diagnosis of the trichomoniasis by ELISA. MSP, current times. Hello.
Yes, sir.
What is current time? Here it is written. A current time period of minimum 60 days is compulsory before bringing new bull into the semen station. Only after favorable result from the health control point, the bull shall be admitted to the semen station. So if you are purchasing or procuring any bull from the outside market, you should not include this bull at a time into the herd of the animal, herd of the bull for the purpose of semen collection. You should wait for minimum of 60 days for direct entry into the 60 days before entry to the herd of bulls. A, in the quarantine station, new animals should be housed for minimum 60 days in a place which is effectively separated and away from the facility occupied by resident bull. Manpower deployed and all equipment used in the handling, feeding, watering, cleaning the new bull shall not be shared with the residents' herds. So these are the points to be remembered while you are procuring a bull to the semen station. Each new animal in quarantine station will be tested against the major contagious disease before it entry to the resident's herd. For the TB, JD, brucellosis, campylobacteriosis, and trichomoniasis, all tests shall be and should to be done by an accredited agency or disease diagnostic laboratory. During quarantine period, the bull shall be vaccinated against the FMD, HSV2, zoonosis, and anthrax. If you are procuring some bull, that bull should be vaccinated against the FMD, HSV2, and zoonosis, and anthrax. However, vaccination against the bacterial disease shall be done only if there is an outbreak or prevalence of the particular disease. Here, you under the note is written, once the quarantine period is over, all bulls shall be introduced to the young bull rearing stations. ऐसा नहीं है कि पहले जो कहले तो rearing station young bull में डालना है ना जो breeding bull में डाल देना है. Testing of bulls. As per OI guideline, the breeding bulls should be free from the above mentioned disease. Though jaundice disease is not a sexually transmitted disease, but from the heart health point of view, bull found positive should be removed. And therefore, it has been included in the MSP. Okay. This disease is testing of bull. Breeding bull free from the above mentioned disease through Jones disease, except the Jones disease. Remove. Therefore, it has been included in MSP. The bull in the rearing station and the resident herd should go through the periodical testing and vaccination as per schedule listed in the manual of minimum standard protocol. A manual is given on the site of the animal husbandry department, minimum standard protocol like manual. So you should go through all this and you will come to know the minimum standard protocols for cement stations. Culling of bull and cement dose due to specific disease. A table has been made, FMD, had bull. If any bull is suffering from FMD, you can retain it. But it's a condition, last 1 month dose to be discarded. Brucellosis, if animal is suffering from brucellosis, castrate and remove. You should not store freezing FS doses. Freezing FS doses, matlab ho gaya freezing of sample to be discarded since last negative test. So if any bull is suffering from brucellosis, it should be casted and removed, not retained. TB, if bull is suffering, it should be removed. JD should be removed. Campylobacteriosis, treat and retain. If anybody, any bull is suffering from vibriosis, after treatment, you can retain it. You can keep trichomoniasis, treat and retain it. So under three diseases, brucellosis and TB, JD, you cannot keep it for the treatments. You should remove from the herds of the bulls, breeding bull herds. Detail of test to be conducted. The semen stations, minimum 60 days or long enough, allow at least 2 tests for MSP disease to be performed during the current trying with minimum interval of 30 days between the 2 tests. Minimum stage 2 tests karna hai at the interval of 30 days between 2 tests. In case of TB and JD, the interval between 2 tests should not be less than 62 days. This is conditions. Hello. Hello, all you are hearing? Hello.
All yes, sir.
Achha, theek hai. Shifting of bull from yes, current time. How could you shift the bull within 30 days from the date when the last test was performed? And all bull were found negative. When bull will found negative within the last 30 days from the date when the last test was performed for diagnosis. Action on finding a positive result. Brucellosis, TB, JD, bovine, trichomoniasis, cull and removes. Cull karo, remove karo. You cannot keep it while animal is suffering from brucellosis, TB, JD, bovine, campylobacteriosis, trichomoniasis. The positive bull and put cull and remove the positive bull and put all the remaining bull under the extended current times. If suffering from trichomoniasis, campylobacteriosis, you can keep it, but you should give under the observation, you should test some test unless it come negatives. Extension, extended current times. For a period of minimum 60 days or long enough to allow these 2 tests for the disease mentioned above to perform from the day last positive bull was culled, to perform the test within 30 days of extended current time. During current time, if the bull are housed and managed, individual remove only by positive bulls in groups. This is given, your slide will be given to you. This is given here, the disease testing and management of bovine tuberculosis semen station. Kaise kaise karna, ye table diya gaya hai. Positive heart testing 40 days is given here. And the reference book has been given. Under these guidelines, you can study details by simply copy this